Good morning. My name is Desiree Stokkel, and today it's 22 November 2016. The Netherlands is officially a republic since 18 November 2016. It's the day that I claim the labor contract with current presidents Mark Rutte and King Willem-Alexander for the reason that they want to start a war against Russia. They need that war in order to keep the International Criminal Court corrupt to their advantage. I started an International Criminal Court law case against the Netherlands in May 2007. I was forced to do so by the Judiciary Council. It was their fun moment. It's fun in the Netherlands to torture and kill people by making them lawless, so they need to fight the rest of their lives in the bureaucracy for constitutional rights. I am a lawless person in the Netherlands. Over the past years, I have received letters from ICC that prove that I lawfully started that ICC law case against the NL, but that ICC refuses to conduct the UN Treaty, the Torture Treaty and Human Rights Treaties when they process on files they receive, resulting in the fact that in Holland we have had election after election based upon lies. We have a fully mad parliament with screamers like Geert Wilders or other screamers. Well, there are too many to name. As a matter of fact, in the Netherlands, 225 members of parliament are all dictators. And they have built the lobby, the Hague Security Delta. That's the lobby behind the International Criminal Court. And on that lobby, King Willem-Alexander, Meester Pieter van Vollenhoven, and other members of the royal family play a significant role in the security. In daily life, it means that the Netherlands has no security left. Security is a fake story created by a fake parliament and a criminal monarchy. When politicians make a country collapse, like the parliaments in the Netherlands have done over the past 9 years, and then suddenly they start to scream, we want a war against Russia, yeah, we have to defend ourselves against Russia, blah blah blah, that results in more crime and more terrorism. On top of that, we have the M817. The M817 would never have taken place when the International Criminal Court would never have lied about an ICC law case against the NL. The people of the M817 plane would be alive today when our political parties, our monarchy, our TV makers, our electoral council or other organizations founded in name of the government would not have lied about the ICC law case against NL. The people can't see it because the media always lies, but Holland is an enormous chaos with more and more individuals becoming lawless, having themselves tortured and murdered. In Holland, a situation is created that judges torment victims and protect perpetrators by giving them light sentences. Judges in Holland are free to lie, torture and murder. So are lawyers. So what you see is a very dangerous movement, namely that the elite, who is supposed to guarantee life in the state of law, the Netherlands, now turn to slimy criminals themselves and destroy the victims. The whole media thing, the whole all those screams have resulted in the fact that I made the move on 18 November 2016 to claim the labor contract of the International Criminal of Mark Rutte. I also claimed it with the International Criminal Court. The president, Sylvia Fernandez de Cornudi, is legally obliged to recognize me as interim prime minister. I will have that labor contract next to dictator Mark Rutte. And that's because we will have elections for parliament 15 March 2017. I have also put in power by decree the constitution Republic the Netherlands, the law referendum and elections, the new law court system Republic the Netherlands and an immigrant law, meaning that we, the Republic, can restart to build a state of law. But what will happen? What you will see the coming months is that our politicians will turn it into a soap. And ICC has a big problem, they can no longer lie. ICC has imploded in front of the in the faces of the people worldwide. And that means in the Netherlands that we are extremely vulnerable. When you understand the chaos, you know how vulnerable we are. And that's what I want to put an end to. So officially, I am the first female interim prime minister of the Netherlands since 18 November 2016. I have not had my labor contract yet. And I expect dictator Mark Rutte to make me fight for it. That's one of my main problems. Every person working for the Ministry of Common Affairs enjoys a war. So I will see what will happen the coming weeks. I have put maximum pressure on the Electoral Council and the Judiciary Council. I have made very clear to them today in a letter that they have to obey me. They must start to work with the Constitution, Republic NL, and all the other laws I just named, and educate the people about the situation. So that means that we will have a regime change in the Netherlands without bloodshed. I have to warn you, I know how the people think inside the Electoral Council and the Judiciary Council. They really, really, really enjoy to murder people. So I maximized the pressure by making clear to them that I will have them put in prison in Russia or Saudi Arabia if they disobey me. Because my commands are to create a state of law for every individual. This is not making myself rich. This is not about making myself a dictator. When everything goes well, we will have the first officially elected prime minister in the Netherlands on 15 May 2017. Then I will hand over my labor contract to the newly elected prime minister on 17 March 2017. Then Holland will be a republic with a good, solid, fair referendum system, Brexit-proof, and Holland will have an enormous amount of cleaner power in the bureaucracy. Goodbye.